Many scholars believe it was one of the most important pieces of legislation in the history of our country, the Morrill Land Grant Act of 1862. Named for Vermont Congressman Justin Morrill and signed by President Abraham Lincoln, the act gave federal lands to the states, which in turn sold that land to establish universities that shared knowledge with the public. And without it,
well, we wouldn't have the dramatic advances that we've seen over the last 150 years in areas like agriculture and engineering.
In 1863, Penn State became one of the nation's first and Pennsylvania's only land-grant institution. The Morrill Act gave Penn State a three-part mission: teaching, research, and service.
What it did is it made higher education available and relevant for the children of the working class, of the Commonwealth, in every state across the country. It made an opportunity for people to transition their lives through education, and it also provided research to help improve the lives of the individuals across the Commonwealth.
Land-grant universities have made a huge difference in the success of this country, in the opportunity that it's provided to men and women.
The historical significance of the Morrill Act is recognized nearly 150 years later at a Penn State land-grant conference.
Penn State is one of the great land-grant universities. It's in our blood here.
It's here that scholars from across the country dissect the history of land-grants and look forward.
The future is actually incredibly exciting.
Today, land-grant universities continue to share research and knowledge with the public, which many say is especially important in tough economic times.
Because of what's happening, the role of land-grant universities such as Penn State is going to be more important, more essential, more critical to the way this country moves forward than it has ever been.
If you look at the complex issues this country's facing, we need smart, researched solutions.
Although scholars believe that land-grant universities will be asked to do more in the future, they do worry about government support.
The land-grant mission, as I've discussed in this conference, is being challenged now because there's very little support from the federal, state government that helps us specifically with that mission.
But they say that land-grant universities won't lose sight of the real meaning.
It's not just about the science and the technology. It's really about people. It's about human development. It's about community development. It's about fostering democracy through our interaction with people.
For Penn State Outreach, I'm Erin Calandra.